أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
صلى الله عليه وسلم. ثم نعود رحمة للعالمين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى أن يبعث الناس لرب العالمين. We listen today in Salatul Isha a few verses from Surah Yusuf, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the last ayah of Surah Yusuf, لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى وَلَكِنْ تَصْدِيقَ الَّذِي بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَتَفْصِيلَ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي قَصَصِهِمْ عِبْرَةٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says and tells us that telling the stories of the prophets, it's for a reason and for a lesson that we should learn. مَا كَانَ حَدِيثًا يُفْتَرَى. It's not just a speech or a story that we tell so we like enjoy and we say subhanallah, mashallah, and that's it. لَقَدْ كَانَ فِي. There is a wisdom of telling the stories of the prophets. And we all know that the whole purpose of being in dunya, it's to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as well as the dunya, it's the place of to be tested. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said at the beginning of Surah Al-Mulk, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي بِيَدْهِ الْمُلْكُ وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةِ. All the praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who has created the death and the life. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ, to test you. أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا, which one amongst you has the best deeds. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفُورُ. And also we have said in Surah Al-Ankabut, in the beginning, alif lam mim, ahasiba an-nasu an yutraku an yaqulu amanna wa hum la yuftanun. Does people think, ahasiba an-nas, do people think, an yutraku, that they will be left, an yaqulu amanna, that they will say we are believers, wa hum la yuftanun, and they will never be tested? It doesn't make sense. So if you have an iman and if you are claiming that you are a mu'min, definitely will be what? He will be tested. And in the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أشد الناس ابتلاء الأنبياء. The most people are tested are the prophets. ثم الأمثل فالأمثل. And the one who is closer, and the more you go down, the more less be tested in this life. So the one who has more test in this life, the one who has more iman. So how the Prophet Ya'qub alayhi salam has dealt with his test, like losing his child, the beloved son Yusuf alayhi salam. They came and they told him, like, give us Yusuf, we will look after of him, we are trustworthy, we will be careful. And they took him, and he said, I'm worried if you took him, you may lose him, or the wolf come and eat it. We all know the story. And they brought a fake blood, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned, وَجَاءُوا عَلَىٰ قَمِيصِهِ بِدَمٍ كَذِبٍ. Fake blood on his shirt. And they said that the wolf, like, we were playing, and then we left Yusuf somewhere, and then the wolf came and ate him. Then what the Prophet Ya'qub alayhi salam has dealt with his test? He said, قَالَ بَلْ سَوَّلَتْ لَكُمْ أَنفُسُكُمْ أَمْرًا. Your selves and your souls and your desires has made or has beautified things for you. Shaytan has came and beautified, we will get rid of Yusuf. So our father, we like, will look after of us, and no one will be in front of his face apart of us. So there is no more Yusuf. قال بل سولت لكم أنفسكم أمرا. And listen to the word, فصبر جميل. فصبر جميل. And this is the main point that we need to focus on, which is الصبر. الصبر, it's a great ibadah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned الصبر in so many different ayahs. Like he says, فصبر جميل. And also, فصبر صبرا جميلة. And also he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. And also he said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَالصَّلَاةِ وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ. And also in the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, مَنِ ابْتَلَاهُ بِفَقْدِ حَبِيبَتَيْهِ. Whoever will be tested, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test him by losing his eyesight, losing his eyes. فَصَبَرْ فَلَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. He was patient, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward him for being patient of losing his eyesight of Jannah. So as-sabr, it's a great ibadah, we all in dunya, and we know that dunya it's the place to be tested, not the place to be the best life. The only place that we have the best life with no problems and with no difficulties in our life is Jannatul Firdaus, which I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us and our parents the highest place of Jannah with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make sabr easy for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our matters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease our difficulties. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us a good life and good end in this dunya. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deeds and efforts. So the main lesson of today is to be patient and train the self and the soul of being patient. As it came in Nama, Al-ilmu bil-ta'allum, gaining the knowledge by going and learning, seeking knowledge. Wal-hilmu bil-tahallum, and to be kind and nice is by training yourself to be like this. Was-sabru bil-tasabbur, is to force yourself to be patient. وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ وَاسْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. وَاسْطَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا is to force yourself to be patient of being in a state of ibadah all the time. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again to make sabr easy for all of us and ease all our matters and difficulties. قُلُوا قَوْلِي هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَصَلِّ اللَّهُمَّ وَسَلِّمْ وَبَارِكْ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَعَلَى آلِهِ وَصَحْبِهِ أَجْمَعِينَ.
وفرق بين من تمشي بسترين ومن تمشي بغير الستر فينا عباءتها على الرأس ارتياح لعين الناظرين الصالحين يراها الناس جوهرة وتبقى كلؤلؤة بعين الناظرين ولم تبرز مفاتنها بيوم لأن النار مثوى الخاسرين وقدوتها رسول الله دوما وتحذو حذو أم المؤمنين فحق لمثلها ألا تبادي إذا انتقدوا هداها الناقصين